If you've done front-end web development for any amount of time, there's a good chance you've probably had to work on a user management table. And it probably wasn't very good. Fortunately, that's not something that you have to do anymore, because we made the WorkOS widget for user management. And it doesn't suck. Let's get into installing it. But before we do, there's a handful of prerequisites. First, the documentation is always going to be the best and most up-to-date way to get information on installing. So even if this video goes out of date, the documentation will be up to date. Second, this video guide takes place after you've done the initial installation of Authkit into a Next.js app. If you don't have that, don't fret. We have a fresh guide on Next 15 and Authkit version 1. You can jump right to that in the card above and come back when you're done. Okay, now let's get into it. Let's start by adding our dependencies to this Next app. We have WorkOS Inc. widgets, Radix UI themes, and TanStack React query. And in this app, I have a new async page as a placeholder in admin users page, and we require authentication for this route in our middleware.ts. With our page ready to go, we now need to set up cores in the WorkOS dashboard. Go to authentication, find the section on cross-origin resource sharing, and allow all of the web origins you want to use. In this case, localhost is all we'll be using today. Now, I like to start these guides from the end, where we actually put the component code in place and run things through every error cycle. I find that it's helpful when you're debugging something on your own to see these errors happen in real time and know that it's perfectly normal and that the errors that you see, while sometimes being confusing, do have a purpose. Grab the import statement for WorkOS widgets and the widget code itself. Of course, user management requires an auth token. To get that token, we'll take the access token as token from function that we import from our Authkit Next.js SDK. We get a skeleton, that's nice, and an eventual error. API error, organization not found, undefined. We see this error when we have a user, but that user is not paired to an organization. We can fix this by putting a user inside of an organization in the organization's page. Simply go to users and select from the search. Now, because we don't get a new token every reload, we need to go back to wherever our login page is, sign out, and sign back in again. This time we still have an error, but hopefully we have an organization ID. But this error is admittedly confusing. It says organization not found, when clearly we have an organization with that ID. Now, this is a security measure, so people can't just guess organization IDs that they don't have access to. This can mean two things. It can mean that a user doesn't have the right privileges in an organization. We can change that by editing the role. I'll use the role admin. But it can also mean that a role doesn't have the right permissions. In roles and permissions, we now have a system level permission for widgets, user table manage. To make sure that all admins have that privilege, we need to edit the admin role and add it as a permission. With that, we should be able to finally get through. And here we are, the full user management widget. We can search, we can filter by role, invite users, and manage their roles. Now, even though we've got this working right now, if we let it run long enough, we will start to see errors start to compound. And that's because Next.js has a kind of confusing relationship between front-end and back-end. And while we have a valid auth token right now, eventually that token will need to be refreshed on the server side, even if we haven't refreshed the page. To fix that, we make it possible to generate widget tokens on the server side. This allows us to have a stable auth token for long-lived pages without having to change your session duration for your entire application. Instead of the access token, we'll now pull a user and an organization ID. Then I'll just swear to TypeScript that we have something here for the benefit of keeping this nice and quick and make sure that I'm using the right variable name. Finally, we need to create a WorkOS instance, import the WorkOS node SDK and import that as well. So here we go. We have the full end-to-end user management widget, and this widget token will ensure that we don't get those weird hiccups and errors down the road. That said, there are two great places for errors. If we don't have an auth token, we may want to return that something went wrong. And if we want to be extra sure that only admins attempt to access this page, possibly getting through our middleware, check against our role here, saying that the person hasn't been authorized and that they might need to contact an administrator. Now, this whole component comes out of the box with really nice styles, but it's also easy to configure thanks to Radix Themes. Radix Themes is an open source component library and design system optimized for fast development, easy maintenance, and accessibility. Let's configure this user table with just a handful of the many options that you can pass to a Radix theme provider. And the WorkOS Widgets provider takes a theme object. We can change the appearance to dark, the accent color to green, the border radius to full, font family to enter, and scale it all up for my aging eyes. Radix Themes should give you plenty of options to map the look and feel to your application. However, if you want to start over from scratch, simply don't include the provided style sheet. This way, you'll have a blank canvas to style with, either using the Radix Themes selectors or the WorkOS widgets specific classes. Okay, so that's it. Last user management table you'll ever need to build, stylable and accessible through Radix Themes. Build atop an enterprise grade auth system. Oh, and banger tutorial. That's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you love these new WorkOS widgets as much as we do. Keep an eye out for our upcoming launch week in this spring, where we have a few more that you might like as well. I'm Chantastic. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.